Hi, and welcome to the show where we share the stories of the many who intersect with our healthcare system but are rarely heard from. My name is Kevin Poe, founder and editor of Kevin MD. Today in the show, we have Mike Wu Ming. He's a physician entrepreneur, and he wrote the Kevin MD article, Why Physician-Owned Businesses Need Our Attention and Support. Mike, welcome to the show.
Kevin, it's been an honor. Thank you for having me.
We'll get into your article in a little bit, but first off, can you share your story and journey to where you are today?
Yeah, I think it's fair to say I'm a pretty unconventional doctor. We've spoken in the past, so you know a little bit about my story, but I'm a family medicine trained, although I haven't done primary care in some time. I've always been entrepreneurial. I started a business in medical school that continued on in a private practice, and I started a consulting company, a marketing company, and a software company, which actually allowed me to retire for some time. But then I still had the itch to come back into medicine, but I wanted to do so on my own terms. And I wanted to see if I could open up a cash pay practice in Southern California, which where I live currently, which is not the easiest thing to do, but somehow we were able to manage to do that. I started in age management and med spa. We're going on next year, 10 years. I've got a dozen employees. And now I work with other physicians who want to find their entrepreneurial journey, either starting up their own side business, online business, or even up opening up their own direct pay practice or med spa. So it's been fun. It's been a fun journey.
I always like to talk about physicians and their interests outside of medicine, because I always say that physicians, we're more than our degrees. Now, why would physicians want to start a business outside of clinical medicine and what they trained in?
You know, it's funny because I think some of my family members are still asking that same question to me. You know, I think we have seen really a phenomenon in the last several years. You've heard the term side gig or side business. And I think it's because physicians are perhaps missing something. Maybe they're not getting gratification in their current, you know, their 9 to 5 or 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. job that they're missing. And I think because of things like the internet, they're allowed to have a voice. And if they have, I always tell my physicians, if you have knowledge or expertise that you can share with others, that could be the formation of a business. And, you know, over the last 10 years, I've been working with physicians who've been able to find that, whether it's physicians helping other physicians with burnout, or maybe I'm working with a physician right now who's involved in real estate investing, and they've developed their own strategies on doing that. And then they work with other clients, helping them start their own real estate business. It can even be, you know, starting up a car wash, whatever that they want to do. They're getting fulfillment, you know, besides obviously the making money aspect, they're getting fulfillment that perhaps they're not getting in their current jobs.
So you're absolutely right. A lot of physicians, they are getting burned out at their clinical job, like you said, the 9 to 5, and I'm sure it goes much longer than 9 to 5 for some other physicians. Now, where can these doctors start if they want to start a business or start something outside of clinical medicine? Where do you recommend they start?
You know, it's different for really depending on what they're doing. I think what it comes down to is, for me, I got involved in businesses back in the late, you know, 90s, early 2000s. And back then, I was really interested in things like, you know, online businesses. Kevin, if you remember back in those days, the dot-com days, we were seeing all this money being thrown out, right, for, you know, online companies starting pet food, you know, selling pet food and delivering those kinds of things. And for me, it was just like getting involved in technology. So I got involved in an online startup because that's what I was interested in. So I think it first comes down to like, what are you interested in? What do you want to do? Whether it be, you know, getting involved in real estate, getting involved in, I don't know, scrapbooking, you know, whatever that is. If there's someone that you see and they're actually like making a living on it, maybe that's where you want to pursue. So it really comes down to your interests and then finding people who are actually doing it and actually making money with it, and then going to them and asking them, how do you like your business? You know, I see so many people who like, they kind of fly to like whatever, like the most exciting thing, and then they flock to it, but they don't realize is that, you know, the backbone is actually having an actual business and actually developing an income so you can continue growing that business.
So there's a perception in some corners that physicians aren't good at business. We're not business savvy. We're not good with money. Now, from all your years of working with physicians in that context, what's your thoughts on that?
You'll probably laugh, but I think it's true to some extent. And it's not because we don't have the smarts to do it. You know, we're all highly educated. You know, we're able to grasp complex information and make it understandable to ourselves and to others. It really comes down to time and time devoted to it. And I think, you know, developing a business is just like any other skill. So for myself, when I got involved in my own business, it was finding a mentor, finding someone who was actually generating a living from it and asking the right questions and then studying it. And then these days, information is everywhere. You know, sign up for a course, you know, read a book, you know, you know, now these days, these things called libraries, right? They have online libraries where you can look up any information you want. Look on YouTube. Information is everywhere. But then I think when it comes to information is then having like a mentor actually disseminating all that and saying, you know what? 90% of this is just kind of like, you don't really need to know it. It's that 10% that can really make a difference in your business.
All right, let's talk about the Kevin MD article that you wrote. It's titled, Why Physician-Owned Businesses Need Our Attention and Support. Now, for those who didn't get a chance to read that article, can you just walk my audience through it and share the story of why you decided to write it?
Yeah, it really came down to what I had been seeing that we talked about at the beginning is this trend about physicians, you know, helping other physicians or helping others, you know, with what I call knowledge-based businesses, helping them, you know, develop, you know, get through burnout, you know, get through, you know, relationships. And I just saw a lot of physicians, you know, started to come, whether it be on social media, starting to develop courses and training and mentoring. And what it really came down to it was what I saw was where they lacked was that education about businesses. And one thing that I feel is one of my strengths is marketing and specifically online marketing. And I wanted them other physicians to recognize that there is this growth of these physician-owned businesses. Let's give them a helping hand. And in the article, I talk about how I got involved with when I was buying my house. I was interested in, you know, I got involved when you're buying a house, you know, finding a realtor. And I stumbled onto a physician who actually had a business that actually catered to working with other physicians, getting them in their home and introducing me to things like, you know, doctor loans and other things that I didn't know about. And it got me thinking that, you know, when I started my marketing company, I was involved in a marketing company where we worked with practices like plastic surgeons and helping them with their reputation management, a lot about in online marketing. And we were able to build that to over 150 clients. And I'm not to say that we were the best in terms of like search engine optimization or pay-per-click advertising, but I was able to get the decision maker because they found out that I was a physician. Mm-hmm. And I was able to talk directly to the owner of the practice and I was able to get their contract because, you know, they felt that they understood what I was going through. And I think there are businesses, you know, a lot of different businesses that are out there that you may not know are being owned by physicians, you know. In my specialty in the age management medical spa industry, the leader of the biggest association in that industry is run by an attorney. And we all know about this death of private practice, right? We know more physicians are employed than going into private practice. And a lot of it comes, you know, there's lots of reasons for it, you know, regulations, the idea of being an entrepreneur, but just in terms of like medical school, where we get zero business training, we don't get to talk to, at least I didn't get to talk to a doctor who was in private practice. And we're going to continually, you know, put dirt on the private practice. And it was just, my article was just a way of just like, hey, just as we support, you know, veteran-owned businesses, or we support mom and pop businesses versus the big conglomerates, why not we start supporting physician-owned businesses? And that's where it starts, is if more physicians can support other physicians, then maybe we can have a voice at the table. Maybe we can be the head of these associations and get back what we've lost.
You mentioned this earlier, but what are some common examples of physician-owned businesses that can be found?
I mean, just sort of an example for what we talked about with burnout. And, you know, there are research has shown, and I talk about it in the article, you know, when it comes to it, a physician would rather talk to another physician when dealing with these issues. And then in terms of their success, you know, matches that when they are able to someone who's kind of been there, who understands what's gone through, may have gone through burnout themselves most of the time. So that is one of the examples, is if you are looking for someone in helping, you know, get through burnout, find a physician burnout coach. Now I see other aspects where it goes through, you know, dealing with relationships. You know, a good friend, she is a very, very well known in the physician relationship coach, and she's a physician herself. So I think in terms of those are where I've seen the biggest growth. But even then, I've seen things like getting involved in investing, getting involved in real estate investing. There are lots of different courses you could take. There are a lot of different quote gurus and mentors you can do. I'm currently going through a course where they're both run by physicians. And, you know, I'm not saying that physicians are the best at everything, but I'm, you know, being said, there is, I kind of make an analogous to like, you know, getting into the military, right, where we support our veterans. I'm not saying that, you know, fighting a war is going through medical school, but in some aspects, you can kind of see, you know, there are some overlapping examples of that, that we understand that they're going through. We understand that with physicians, hopefully, you know, they have the right ethics, they understand us, they understand that we're busy. And for a lot of times, I don't want to go through all of the muck. I want to get the answer. You know, my time is busy. I have problems and I need problems solved. And I feel like a physician-owned business, more times than not, it's usually the right decision when I go with someone who is a physician.
Where can doctors find physician-owned businesses? Is there some type of repository or central place where doctors can look for other doctor-owned businesses?
Well, you know, this is probably self-serving, but I do own a directory. And the reason why I started it, because I had the same question. I wanted for other physicians, my clients, where could they find other coaches? So I started up just like a good entrepreneur would. If I couldn't find the solution, I started it myself. And it's called physiciancoaches.com. And there's over 150 physicians that you can choose. It's completely free, where you can find physicians who get involved in leadership, in relationships, in investing, in, you know, helping them with losing weight. Anyone that you can choose to, you can go in, you can find it, you can read about their bio, you can go to their website, and you can contact them for free. Most of the times, you do a free consultation, and it's been great, and it's been growing ever since. And I'm sure there are other sites like this. You know, there are, you know, the thing is, it's very difficult to find. You know, it is difficult to find, but I know, like, when I work with a small business, a lot of times, like in your own private practice, you know, as I said, private practice is dying. I still like that mom and pop. And, you know, most of the times it's not run by a solo physician. So you do have to do some digging, but, you know, ask the right person, is this run by a physician themselves, or is this owned by, you know, some big private equity firm? And, you know, they may or may not give you the answer, but that's where to start.
We're talking to Mike Wu Ming. He's a physician entrepreneur, and he wrote the Kevin MD article, Why Physician-Owned Businesses Need Our Attention and Support. Mike, for those physicians who are interested in doing a proverbial side gig or starting a business, what are some of the biggest mistakes that you see them do?
Well, there's a lot. I think that the biggest thing is what I alluded to earlier, is they kind of like say, you know, physicians, you know, we're human and we want to go to like what's hot. So they kind of looked and say, oh, you know what? A lot of people are making money in this, so I'm just going to start a business in that. And that's usually like the biggest disaster that I can see. Another thing too is, you know, people also say, you know, you need to go to what you're passionate about. And to some extent, I agree to that. But, you know, I'm passionate about a lot of things. You know, I'm passionate about, like, you know, 80s retro songs, but I'm not going to make a living out of that. It's really getting involved in seeing who's actually making money. Is it something that you're passionate about? And for themselves, do you have some type of specialized knowledge that you can, you know, enter into this industry? And that's kind of where it starts. And in addition is I think the biggest mistake is not finding a mentor. Mm-hmm. You know, I think as physicians, we tend to be, we want to do everything themselves. And like I said, there's information everywhere. You know, if you wanted to start up your own med spa, there's information that's freely available. But there's a lot of information out there that's wrong or outdated. So if you're wanting to start up your own med spa or your own direct pay practice, whatever you want to do, find a mentor, contact them, see what it really is. More times than not, you might find that there's a lot of headaches or a lot of obstacles that you may not have anticipated. There may be a lot of money that you need to invest that you may not have known before. So it's like anything, you need to do your due diligence.
And my final question, what's your take-home message that you want to leave with the Kevin MD audience?
You know, I think is really, if you want to do this, physician entrepreneurship is not for everybody. There's lots of ways that you can make money. For myself, in being involved in business, for me, it really fulfilled a lot of needs that I needed, a need to help others, a need to teach, to educate. And that's why I got involved. But I think the biggest take home is don't let that discourage you. You know, if you have an idea, don't just ruminate about it. Do something every day. If this is something that you want to do something every day to push you forward. You know, maybe watch that YouTube video, maybe make that phone call to a mentor, maybe make a free consultation on physician coaches. Whatever it is, don't let it stagnate. You know, when we stagnate, nothing happens. You know, it's all about moving forward is what I like to say.
And how can people reach you?
You know, just like that site that I mentioned, physiciancoaches.com is probably the best site. You can contact us if you want to be a coach yourself. We do have some training involved. We're happy to talk with you, happy to help you out if this is something that you want to pursue.
Mike, thank you so much for sharing your time and insight. And thanks again for being on the show.
Thanks, Kevin. It's been a pleasure.